Fiona Forrestal and I'm the executive chef for Sodexo in Ireland. Today I'm going to make one of the really, really simple dishes that you can make. It's really versatile and it can be adapted to suit any pastas that you have in your cupboard at home. So just to start, I'm going to use some low-fat milk. And just for the rest of the ingredients, we have some butter, we have some low-fat cheddar cheese, but you could use full fat or parmesan if you wished. I have some dried bay leaves, some black peppercorns, a whole onion which I've just cut in half. I have some chives to finish, some flour, and I have some macaroni as well. But as I said, you can use whatever pasta you have. So just to start, I'm going to pour my milk into a pot. And basically what we're going to do is add some seasonings to the milk. Milk is one of the most nutritious foods that you can have. It's known as a complete food. The only thing it's missing is a carbohydrate. And I suppose the pasta and the flair will add that, so you'll have a complete dish to serve to yourself or to your family. So in the pot I've added the milk. I'm also going to add the onion. No need to chop, just cut it in half and peel it and pop it straight in to the pot. I'm going to add some bay leaves, and again, you can get these dried. These are like one of your really good basic store cupboard ingredients, because when they're actually added to liquid, they add lots of flavour. They work really, really well with chicken and mince. So again, if you're kind of limited on space or budget, this is something that I would absolutely recommend you have. We have some whole black peppers, and again, we're going to add this in. And I suppose the whole black pepper is very different to, you know, dried pepper that's already ground. This is a much softer flavour, so if you're going to use, you know, cracked black pepper, you need to just reduce the amount down a little bit. I'm going to add a little pinch of thyme as well, just because I have it to hand. And again, this will just add a really, really nice earthy tone to the milk. So what you want to do is put this on, and what you want to do is just bring it just shy of boiling, because if you boil it, it'll just overflow. So what you want to do is just bring it to a nice little boil. Keep an eye on it, and then once it comes to the heat, all you need to do is we're just going to leave it to the side. You can put a plate over the top, or if you cling film, you can cover it. And basically what that's going to do is infuse all the flavour back into the milk. So really you want it closed, and that will hit off the top and then bounce back into your liquid. So we'll leave that for 20 minutes once that comes to the boil. I also have my pot here, and to that pot I'm just going to add some salt. The reason I'm doing that is pasta is really, really bland, so if you add some salt into the water, it'll actually kind of season the pasta for you. Now, if you have pasta, whole grain is, I suppose, the preferred option. Again, it has all the fibre in it. And I'm just going to pop what I have here with macaroni. So I'm just going to pop the macaroni in there. What you want to do is just give that just a little stir, just so it won't stick. And then just cook to your manufacturer's guide. Normally it's about 8 to 10 minutes, depending on the brand. So our milk has been sitting for, I suppose, 20, 25 minutes. So now I'm just going to strain it, and you can see the milk will actually have changed slightly in colour, and that's just from the ingredients infusing their flavours into it. So just discard this because there's no flavour left in that anymore, it's all gone into your milk. So now to make the sauce, just have a little pan here on the go, and I'm just going to add some of my diced butter. And what you want to do is let that butter melt, and it's equal quantities of butter to flour. And that is what's called, I suppose, a roux. And basically it's just a thickening agent, which you can use it for the basis of quite a lot of sauces. And the sauce that I'm making now, I'm going to put into the pasta. However, if you were making a lasagna, this would also act as the sauce that you would put over the top of your pasta layers and your mince. But it also can be used if you had some nice, I suppose, tinned tuna, or even if you had some fish mix, you could add it to that, and again, that could become a fish pie. So you can make this sauce in batches, and you can keep it ready and use. It probably lasts 2 to 3 days in your fridge, so you can have, I suppose, a number of dishes ready. So once that butter and your flour comes together, start adding your milk, just a little bit at a time. And basically what you want to do is just stir it between each addition, and this will help it from getting any lumps. As you can see, it comes together really nicely, and the flavour, you can smell the bay leaf from the onions from the sauce. So it come together at all these steps, and you just continue to add more liquid as you need it. Your pasta now at this stage should be nearly there or thereabouts. And basically what I'm going to do is drain the pasta. We're going to work it into our sauce and then just put it into a hot oven ready to crisp. I like to add some of the cheese just at the very, very last minute, and that gives it like a really nice cheesy topping as well on the top. And I mean, if you had different varieties of cheeses, you could add different flavours to it as well. So I suppose feel free to use whatever you have, or if you just want to experiment, it's a really good sauce to do that with. So I'm just going to keep stirring that. So our sauce is after coming together nicely. It's of the right consistency, so really, I suppose the qualities of a good sauce are that there's a really nice shine, so you can see the shine coming off that. There's no lumps anymore at this stage, and we're going to just add some cheese. Like I said, I'm probably going to add maybe 3/4 of this cheese just to the actual sauce, and then we'll sprinkle some cheese over just to finish. You can add some herbs at this stage. I have some chopped chives, so I'm going to add a small little bit of chopped chives. And again, this just kind of gives another little layer of onion flavour to the dish, but it's very, very mild. It's not very strong or overpowering. But if you had some parsley or you had another herb of your choice, you can add to it. So we just mix that. So that's our sauce then ready to go. So at this point, I'm just going to take it off the heat because we don't want it to catch the pan. And our pasta has come to the boil and is ready to go. So you'll see it has swelled. So you get quite a lot of volume from the pasta. So I'm just going to strain it now. And just pop it into a bowl. And just put that there. And then I have a serving dish here as well. What you want is an oven proof dish, because you can either grill it or you can actually put it into the oven as well. So it really just depends on the equipment that you have available to you. So if you mix the sauce through the pasta, you can see the cheese is starting to melt, so it's been stringy already. So give that a little stir. So just coat all the pasta through. And as I said, at this point, I mean, if you had some cooked ham left over or chicken, feel free to add anything, because it's a really good base that you have here. I'm just going to pour that into our dish, like so. And then I'm just going to give it a final sprinkle of cheese. Again, that'll just add like a lovely little brown crunchy texture to the top. But again, if you have breadcrumbs or even, you know, you had some other herbs that you wanted to add on top, please do so. And then I'm just going to sprinkle a small little bit of chives, and I'll just keep a little bit just for the very end. So I'm just going to pop that into an oven, or again, if you had a grill, you can do that either. So just leave it in there, and that'll take, you know, maybe 12 to 15 minutes, just depending on the setting that you have available to you. So our pasta now has been in the oven for about 12 to 15 minutes. So I'm just going to take it out. Just be really careful, because it does get really, really hot. So I'm just going to lift it out. And then put it down to the side. Now, as you can see, it's after getting a nice colour. I'm literally just going to spoon it into two little cereal bowls, because like I said, this is quite a dense dish, so it's actually quite filling, so a little goes a very long way. So I'm just going to pour that in, and then if you had some nice garlic bread or a side salad, this would work really, really well. And you can see the cheese has really become really stringy in the dish, which is really, really nice, because I suppose it just kind of gives a little bit of excitement if you're serving it to children as well. So that is it. I'm just going to turn it around. As I said, you could finish it with some herbs on top if you wish, but the chives are there, so it's quite strong enough. So there we are, there's my